Good morning, students. So today we will do our first chapter, that is food and its sources. So before this discussion of this chapter, I just want to give the introduction of the chapter, that which topic we will do. So first of all, we will do food and its importance, and after that sources of food. Then next is types of animals on depending on their food habit, and after that the last topic, that is food chain and food web. So first of all, here you can see the food. So food, what is food? When we are thinking about, I think everybody know that what is food, why we eat it, okay? So what is the definition? How can we explain it, that what is food? So simply, in simple word, you can say that food is a substance that we eat to get energy. Okay, is it clear to you? That food is a substance that we eat to get energy. So why we eat food? What is the importance of this food? So here I am writing, why we eat the food means importance of food. Okay. So first, as I already mentioned in the definition only, that it gives us energy. It gives energy. Energy means, like, as if you are, now I am explaining the topic that is given in this chapter. So for that I need energy. That's why I'm standing here. Like if you are listening to me, if you want to do study, if you want to play, and your parents also doing work at home, so they need energy for that thing. Okay, so how they get that energy? By food. Okay, by eating food. And the second importance of this food is that it repairs our worn out cells. So worn out means, here I am highlighting it, worn out means damaged means jo kharab ho chuke hote hain. Okay, so damage, sometime when we are suffering with any fever, infection, we have throat infection, okay, at that time some cells that we are having in our body, they are damaged. At that time, doctors or elders suggest us to eat a good and healthy diet. Okay, why? To repair and worn out, to repair the worn out cells. And third thing, that it protects us from various diseases. It protects us from various diseases. Now how, as I in second point I mentioned that it repair the worn out cell. So how, if it repair the worn out cell, it mean it is protecting us from the diseases, na? So these are some importance of the food, that why we eat the food. Now after this, one thing I want to tell you about the food, that when we prepare any food, for more, Manlo, if you want to prepare a dish, that is tea. Simple example I am taking here, for tea, to make tea we need tea leaves, okay, and second one is sugar we need, and after that water, then fourth one is milk. So these things that we need to prepare our tea, those are known as ingredient of food. Okay, the substance that we need to make a particular dish are known as the ingredient. Okay, so here these are the ingredient to make the tea, as it is given in your book also, dosa. If you want to make dosa, for that you need first of all rice, and the second one is pulse. Okay, so these two are the ingredient to make a dosa. Okay, now after this I will explain you about the sources of food. So from where we get it, like humne bol diya that we want to make tea, from where we get those substances that we need to make tea. Okay, so first of all, see here, sources. Sources of food. So there are mainly two types of sources. First one is, I'm writing here plants, okay, and second one is animal. So plants, how, as if we are talking about dosa, so for dosa we need, see here I'm explaining it with the example. For dosa we need first of all rice and we need pulse. Okay, so by using these two substances we can make dosa. So these rice and pulses are the ingredient. Now from where we get this? So rice is a plant. Okay, rice is a plant and pulse is also a plant. So it means directly we are getting these ingredients from the plants. Now one more example I have already given, that is tea. So in tea you know that we need milk also. Milk, from where we get it? Cows and buffaloes. Cow and buffaloes. So these cow and buffaloes are, what are these? These are animals. Okay, so these are two types of sources of food, plants and animals. And one more thing, that which type of food we get from the animals? Not only milk, we also get some as you know, some persons are non-vegetarian, they like to eat meat in their diet. So we get meat also from the animals. Like, what are the example for that? Hen, okay, and goat, you can also write here. So these are some animals that from which we get the meat. And one more example, that is milk, I already told you. Okay, and egg is also there, that we obtain eggs from hens. Okay, ducks. So these eggs are also used as our diet. And one more thing that is very important, I am telling you, that honey. So how honey? Honey is also obtained from animals. As you know, honey is obtained from honeybees. So honeybees, what are honeybees? Honeybees are the comes in the category of animals. Okay, now after this I just want to explain that how we obtain the honey from the honeybees. Kaise wo banate hain, okay? So for this I will explain it. Just wait. So honey is obtained from honeybees. Okay, honeybees. Now what they are doing in to preparing this honey? So first of all, what are honeybees do? They sit on a flower. As you know, flower contain a sweet juice in them, that is known as plant. I'm writing here that plant store one sweet juice in them, store sweet juice in their flower, sweet juice in their flower. So how? So when the honeybees sit on them, when the honeybees sit on the flower, they suck that juice from the flower and store in their body. After that they use this sweet juice, okay, and store it into their beehives. So this sweet juice is known as nectar. So question can come that what is nectar? Then you can say that nectar is a sweet juice which is present in the flower of the plant. Okay, so after sucking the nectar from the flower, they store it in their beehives. Okay, beehives mean jo unka ghar hota hai, chhatte hote na unke, so in that they store this nectar. Okay, clear? So this is, after this I just want to give overview of the next topic, that is categories of animals depending on their food habit, depending on food habits. Okay, so food habit means that what they want to, what they like to eat. So depending on those food habit, we can categorize the animals into mainly three categories. So first one is carnivore. So carnivore are those animals which like to eat only meat. They eat only meat. For example, as you know, loin, okay? Loin is there, tiger is there, and one hawk is there, okay? So these are some, eagle is also there. So these are some animals which come in the category of carnivores. Now, what they have, special things they have, that they like to eat meat only, because God has given them special features, special teeth. Special teeth means they have sharp teeth, sharp and long teeth, okay, long teeth. So why? Because as you know, they firstly they have to catch the prey. So for that they need sharp and long teeth, and after that they want to tear that flesh of those animals. So that's why they have sharp and long teeth. And second category is herbivores, okay? So the animal which like to eat only plants. For example, what are the example for the herbivores? Cow and buffaloes. I'm writing here that, for example, cows and buffaloes, okay? Now they have also special features. Why they love to like to eat the plants only? Because they have special teeth. They have also special teeth. First of all they have sharp teeth. For what? Sharp teeth to cut the grass. Grass ko cut karne ke liye they need sharp teeth. And after that, they one more variety of teeth they have, that is known as flat and grinding teeth. Okay, so flat and grinding teeth, as you know, after cutting the grass they have to chew that food, they have to chew the plants, okay? So for that thing they have flat and grinding teeth. Now last one that I will discuss today with you, that is omnivores, okay? Third one is omnivores. Omnivores are those animals which like to eat both plant and animals, okay? Like to eat both plants and animals, okay? So what are the example for these? For example, you can write here human beings, because some humans, as you know, we eat chapati, vegetable in our daily life, but some person like to eat meat in their daily life also in routine, okay? So those are known as omnivores, because wo plants bhi kha sakte hain and they can eat the flesh of other animals also, okay? Human beings. And one more example, dog. Dog is also the same one. Dog can eat the chapati and they can eat the meat. So these are some example of omnivores animals. Now they have also both type of teeth. They have sharp teeth and grinding teeth. Cut karne ke liye they have sharp teeth, and to grind the food they have flat and grinding teeth. Okay.